All right, let's lie down. We're gonna start on our backs because I can't waste another second on this, seriously. And then just allow your focus to come to your breathing, in and out through the nose. Take a moment here to arrive on your mats. Whenever I have like these mornings that are like tricky like this, I really appreciate the opportunity to be still and to connect to my breath and just kind of linger in that moment. And so, regardless of where you're coming from right now, giving yourself the opportunity to be here on your mat with your breath. And falling into a rhythm with your breath. Allowing it to deepen, allowing it to smooth out. Feeling the end of the inhale, feeling the end of the exhale. And everything else in between. Couple more breaths here. And then stretch your arms overhead. You get a long line from your hands to your feet. And then hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a good squeeze here, both knees in. And then drop your left foot to the ground, cross your right ankle on your left thigh. It's like a figure four, ankle to knee, whatever you want to call it. Press the right knee open gently, and then take both legs to the left. So just kind of keep this shape and take both legs over to the left. And then really gently pressing that right knee open. Beautiful. Perfect. Nice full deep breath. Come back to center and then simply switch that. Cross left to right. Little pause and then both knees go over to your right. Come back to center. Draw the knees back in. Curl the shoulders up off the ground. Take a breath in. And then exhale, twist. Come into center, inhale. And then exhale, twist. Good. And just move with your breath here. Really make this a breath exercise. Not worrying about working abs. Worrying instead. Not worrying at all, actually. But focusing as that on your breath. Creating a connection between your breath and your movement. Couple more like that. Last one. Come back to center, knees hug in, just release the head down. Receive that movement. And then make your way to your hands and your knees. Perfect. Great. Okay, hands and knees. Right leg is gonna extend back. Tuck the toes of the right foot into the ground. Good. Now you're gonna rock forward and back a couple times, pressing back into that heel as you go back. And working the toes to kind of press forward as you come forward. A few times, yep, perfect, so good. And then hold it in your center, and then inhale, the right leg lifts up. Beautiful, left arm extends forward. Take a breath in, and then exhale, elbow, knee together. Inhale, extend, and then exhale, contract and draw in. Do that three more times on your own. Good, beautiful. So nice. We're gonna hold it open. Stay there or bend the back leg, reach back for your foot with your hand, totally optional, and then kick your foot into your hand. Gorgeous, yes. Start to crawl the gaze forward. Engage the right glute, so really working that right hip in this position, pushing the foot into the hand. Take another breath in. Pull your heel toward your sitting bone to release, if you have the foot, so good. Release your hand down, but keep your leg up. Kick your left foot over to the right. So literally pick up your left foot, move it over to the right, and then bring your right knee behind your left knee, and then sitting back into Gomukhasana legs. Beautiful. Take a breath to rise up. And then exhale any amount forward. It might be like a millimeter, it might be deeper. You'll find what works for you here. So pretty, yes. Use this moment of still to keep the rhythm of your breath going. So we create tempo in the breath, and then we see if we can sustain it, whether we're moving or we're in stillness. Inhale, rise back up, reach up, and then shift forward, reach forward. Little pause, stretch the right leg back, tuck the left toes, three-legged dog. Yes, if it feels good, bend your knee and open your hip. Good, if it doesn't, you can leave it off. Inhale, lift the leg back. And then exhale, place your foot forward between your hands. Left knee comes down. And then rise up on Vinyasa. Push into your back foot. Press into your front foot. Draw the feet toward each other. And squeeze the left glute. All the muscles of the left hip. And then just a tiny little shift forward. Because if you're squeezing, there's not that big of a shift forward. And you start to feel the front of that left hip and thigh. So good. Take another breath here. Release your hands down. Left hand down, left toes tucked, straighten the back leg, take your right hand to the sky. Perfect, beautiful. Mm-hmm. Still keeping those feet pulling toward each other. Yeah. Take another breath in. Right hand releases down, right leg straightens any amount. Blocks are wonderful here. And then re-bend the front leg. Step back to plank, breath in. And then to the belly, exhale. Feet stretch back, hands stretch back, heart stretches forward. Work the muscles of your posterior chain. That would be your glutes, the backs of your legs, your upper back, your erector muscles. And then hands under the shoulders, hands and knees. Stretch your left leg back, tuck the toes. You're gonna go forward and back a few times here. So you're getting a nice stretch in the Achilles, in the ankle. You're also waking up the toes of that back foot. And then hold it forward. Scoop the belly in, float the left leg up. Good. Right arm extends forward. Take a breath in to get long. Exhale, contract and draw in. Inhale, extend. Exhale, draw in. Inhale, exhale, inhale, Exhale. One more time. Open up. Stay there or bend the back leg. Find the foot, kick the foot away. So nice. Yes, beautiful. Beautiful. Left glute engaging. Good. To come out of this, we pull the heel to the hip, reach overhead, extend the leg. Right hand releases down, tuck the toes. Three-legged dog, open the hip if it feels good. And then step your left foot forward. Right knee softly to the ground. Anjaneyasana, rising up, squeeze your right glute. Lift your heart and then shift just a little forward. Draw the front leg and the back leg toward each other energetically. Take a breath in, release your hands. Right hand down, right toes tucked, left hand to the sky, right knee lifts up with power. Take another inhale. Left hand comes down and straighten both of the legs. Melt over the front leg, extending the heart forward. Mm-hmm. Really nice. Bend the front leg. Plank with an inhale. Your belly with your exhale. Shalabhasana, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Beautiful, well done. Smooth out your breath. Rise to your toes, inhale. Bend your knees, look forward, bring your feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. And then fold, exhale. Root to rise, inhale. Bring your hands into your heart, exhale. Finding tempo, inhale, rising up. Exhale, bowing forward. Inhale, halfway. Plank, exhale. Stay for your inhale. Exhale to your belly, please. Cobra, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Yes, yes. Inhale, lift your heel. Bend your knees, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Root to rise, inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Really good. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, bowing. Halfway, inhale. Plank, exhale. Take an extra breath, inhale. Chaturanga or the floor, you choose. Back bend of your choice, up dog, cobra, shalabhasana. Downward facing dog, exhale. Just one breath, inhale. Stay here, exhale. Lift your heels, inhale. Bend your knees, look forward, feet to hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold deeply, exhale. Rise to stand, inhale. Hands into your heart, exhale. Rise, inhale. Exhale, bow. Halfway, inhale. Make your way to downward facing dog. Maybe right to chaturanga, maybe plank and lower. Stay in your breath. Beautiful. Inhale, lift your heels. Bend your knees, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale, so nice. Exhale, fold. Root to rise, inhale. Yes. Draw your hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, rise. Exhale, bow. Halfway, inhale. Chaturanga, or your choice of movement to down dog. Yes. One full breath. Inhale, lift your heels. Stretch back, feet to your hands.
Halfway, inhale. Bow down, exhale. Inhale, heart to sky, rise up. Hands to heart, exhale. Last time, inhale, rise up. Exhale and bow. Halfway, inhale. Make your way back. Yes. Really nice, really nice. Inhale, lift your heels. Bend your knees, look forward, feet to hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. And hands into your heart, exhale. Beautiful. Inhale, right knee lifts up, right knee lifts up. Mm-hmm. Good. Cross your ankle on your thigh. And then sink down. Yes. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Inhale, rise up. Take your left hand to your right knee. We're gonna do this a few times, so stick with the knee for the first one. I promise you'll get to go straight leg when you want to. Later, because you might want to now, but I don't want you to go there yet. So just hold the knee, open up the chest. Come back around through center, beautiful. Push your right foot through. Standing split, bring your hands down to the ground and pause here. Good. Play with this however you want. So you can have your hands right up on top of your standing leg. You can walk the hands a little forward. You can literally hold on to your standing leg. It's up to you. We're gonna do this a few times, so give yourself the freedom to play. I'm a big fan of not doing the same thing all the time, of mixing it up and trying new things. Good. You're gonna start to bend your left knee, your standing leg, step your right foot to the back of your mat. Crescent pose, rise up. Good, take a couple breaths here. Feel your foundation, feet draw toward each other. Right glute engaged, draw the heart toward your thumb. So good. Beautiful. Take another breath in and then release your hands down. Straighten your front leg with an inhale and then a little pause here. You've been here. Shouldn't feel totally foreign. Gorgeous. One more inhale and then bend your front leg. Step back to plank, breath in. Lower chaturanga or the floor. Your back bend of choice and downward facing dog with your exhale. Beautiful. Right leg stretches back, inhale. Right foot comes between your hands. Crescent pose, inhale. Take a few breaths here, squeeze the left glute. Pull the feet toward each other, send the heart to the thumb. Maybe send the heart to the ring fingers. Take the thumbs back even more. One more breath in. Release your hands down, straighten your front leg. Bow down over the front leg, take a breath or two. And then soften the front knee, step to the top of your mat with your left foot. Come halfway with your inhale, and then fold with your exhale. Chair, inhale. Pick up your left knee. Good, and then cross your left ankle and your right thigh. And then sink down. Mm-hmm. Beautiful, beautiful. Yes. Good, just the knee on this first one. Come on up, right hand to left knee twist. How broad can you make your chest? How strong can you make your standing leg? And can you lift your spine from pressing the right foot down more? Come back around through center. Push your left foot back, standing splits on the right leg. Quiet. check in with your breath. Keep the tempo. Bend your standing leg. Pull your heart forward. Left leg lands lightly, or left foot rather, and then rise up, crescent pose. Beautiful. Bend the back knee as much as you need to lift the pelvis, to lift the heart. And then stretch the heart for your ring fingers. Stretch your gaze upward if it feels okay. Good. Release your hands down. Straighten your front leg. Rebend your front leg. Step back to plank. Breath in and plank. Chaturanga. Exhale. Or your choice of how you pass through. From down dog, left leg stretches back and hip. Raise your left foot forward. Crescent for a breath. Rise up. Release your hands down. Exhale. Straighten your front leg. Inhale. Rebend your leg. Exhale. Step your right foot to your left foot. Come halfway. Inhale. You're at the top of your mat. Hold. Exhale. Good. Chair. Right knee lifts. Cross the ankle. Sink down. Rise back up. Take the foot or the knee with the left hand. Open up. Beautiful. Come back around through center. Standing splits. Stay with standing splits, or if you want, you can take a little hop up for a handstand. Left foot comes down if you hopped up. Right foot to the back of the mat. Crescent pose. Inhale. Hands to the ground. Exhale. Straighten the front leg. Inhale. And then bend the front leg. Exhale. Plank. Inhale. Lower down. Exhale. Curl your heart. Inhale. Downward facing dog. Exhale. Right leg stretches back. Inhale. Right foot steps forward. Exhale. Crescent. Inhale. Exhale. Hands down. Straighten the front leg. Rebend the leg. Step to the top of the mat. Inhale. Halfway. And then fold. Chair. Inhale. Left knee lifts. Cross and sink. Rise back up. Take the foot or the knee, twisting open. Come back around through center. Standing splits on the right leg. Good. Stay there. Maybe kick it up. Right foot comes back down. Left foot to the back of the mat. Crescent with an inhale. Bring your hand down with your exhale. Front leg straightens. Inhale. Rebends. Exhale. Plank. Inhale. Beautiful. Lower. Exhale. Inhale. Rise. So good. And downward facing dog. Left leg stretches back. Inhale. Left foot comes forward. Exhale. Inhale. Crescent. Exhale, hands down. Inhale, straighten the front leg. Exhale, bend the front knee. Step to the top of your mat. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Chair, inhale. Right knee rises. Cross the ankle. Sinking down. Maybe hands to the ground. Maybe wrap the right foot around the left shoulder. Tip forward, extend the left leg back. Come back out the same way you came in. So good. Twisting to the right, take the foot or the knee. Beautiful. Come back through center. Standing splits, or maybe take a little handstand lift up. Left foot comes down. Right foot to the back of the mat. Crescent, inhale. Listen, bring your hands to the ground. Straighten the front leg, root the back heel. Pull your heart forward, right hand stays down, left hand to the sky. Take a few breaths here. Yep, so just a variation on revolved triangle. One more breath in. Release your hand down, bend the front knee, step back to plank. Breath in. Lower down. Rise. Downward facing dog. Right leg back. Inhale. Right foot forward. Exhale. crescent, inhale. Hands down, exhale. Inhale, straighten the front leg, root the back heel. And then open up right hand to the sky. Beautiful. Beautiful. Feet draw toward each other, heart pulse toward the front of your mat. One more breath in. Release the hand down, soften the front knee, step to the top of your mat. Halfway inhale. Fold, exhale. Chair inhale. Left knee lift up. Cross your ankle. You don't have to go anywhere, but if you want, hands come down. Wrap this left foot around the right shoulder. You got to take the hands forward and tip forward. If the hands are too close to your foot, it's going to be really hard to fly. Come back out the way you came in. Beautiful. We twist to the left. Take the foot or the knee. Come back through center. Hands down, standing splits, handstand if you want. Right foot down, left foot to the back of the mat. Crescent, inhale. Release your hands down. Straighten the front leg, root the back heel, pull the heart forward, and then sweep the right hand to the sky. Good, release the hands down. Back to plank, inhale. Lower down, exhale. Rise open and downward facing dog. Left leg back, inhale. Place your foot forward, exhale. Crescent, inhale. Hands down, exhale. Root the back heel, straighten the front leg. Left hand to sky. Release the hand down, step to the top of your mat. Halfway inhale. Fold, exhale. Chair, inhale. Press up to stand and bring your hands into your heart. Inhale, chair, so good. Bow forward, exhale. Halfway, inhale. Move back to downward facing dog. Really nice, beautiful. Take a breath in, stretch the right leg back. Right knee to your chest, place your right foot forward. Warrior one, rise up. I like a wide stance here. Whenever I say wide, I mean like right and left. Long too, but like wide. Yeah, beautiful. Really nice. And again, send your heart to your ring fingers. Send the fingers to the sky. Let the back body expand. Back leg straight and strong. One more breath in. And bring your hands into your heart. Tip forward, come onto your back toes. Pause. You're gonna kind of stretch back and forward like we did on all fours before. We weren't on all fours. We had two hands and one knee down, but we started in quadruped. Beautiful. And then you're gonna use the back toes and you're gonna push off. Warrior three, Virabhadrasana. Beautiful. Beautiful, yes, I see you. Bend your standing legs. Keep your hands at your heart or bring them to your heart if they weren't already there. And then bring your pinky fingers onto your, like, your thigh or your knee of your right leg. So you've got this connection of your chest leaning toward your knee. Yes, beautiful. And then can you lift your back leg up a little higher? Kind of pitch the spine forward. Nice. Release your hands down. Step back to plank. Breath in. Lower down. Exhale. Rise. Inhale. Dog. Exhale. Left leg back with your inhale. And then step your left foot forward. Warrior one, root the back heel, rise up the center. Generous bend in the front knee. Yeah. I have a tendency to want to have like my knee shy of like being on top of my ankle. Like I just do. I can catch myself now that everything's recorded. Try to bend the knee enough that the knee is on top of the heel. And the way that we make that easier is by making the back leg stronger. Root back even more. And then send the arms up. Use your back body, use your back rib cage. Use your right glutes. Bring your hands into your heart. Dip forward, come onto the right toes and just go forward and back a couple times. So wake up the ankle, wake up the toes. Inner right thigh is gonna lift, you're gonna push off, pull from the front foot, warrior three. You can keep your hands at your heart, but you can explore if you want as well. Really nice, really nice. Yes. We start to transition here, just starting to bend the knee. And if your hands were not at heart, bring them back in. And then we're gonna find a connection from your heart to your thumbs, pinky fingers to your left thigh. And then start to lift the right leg higher and tip the torso over. Keep the left knee bent. And hug the left hip in and back. Use your right hip to lift the leg higher. Hands come down to the ground. Step back to plank, breath in. Breath out to lower down. Rise, inhale. Knees down, exhale. Come upright, Ustrasana. Inhale, lift the heart. Doesn't have to be big. Rise, inhale. Forearms come to the ground. Tuck your toes, forearm plank. Beautiful. Good. Use your toes, ankles strong. Gorgeous, yes. Push the ground away, spread your shoulder blades. And so I wonder where my home is, where I come from, how the maker sold it, like constellations. Hips release down, heart lifts, toes point back, sphinx. Gorgeous, yes. One more breath in. Soften. Downward facing dog. Right leg stretches back, inhale. Right knee comes to your left elbow. Extend the right leg out to the left, pinky side of the right foot down, and then pull your gaze forward. Stay high on the left toes, pull the heart forward even more. Good. So really getting into that outer right thigh, outer right hip maybe. Inhale, sweep the leg up and back. Open the hip. If you like wild thing, go ahead, flip over. If you don't want it today, skip it. Really nice, yes. Fantastic. Come back around. Bring your right hand down. Bring your right foot outside of your right hand. Good. Back knee can come down if it feels good. And then back knee can bend if it feels good. Reach back and find your foot. I like to lift up a little here now. I used to like to sink down, but now I like to lift up. And instead of resting the hips, really get the sense of kind of pressing away from the ground. Maybe even lift the left hand up to the sky. Beautiful. Beautiful. My home is where I wander. My home is where I wander. Really nice. One more breath in. Release the foot if you have it. Bring the hands around. Walk the right foot across for pigeon. So if pigeon doesn't work, consider rolling onto your right hip, bending your left knee, and being here in kind of like a free-form pigeon. If you're comfortable in pigeon, working the back leg long and straight. Really nice. Always taking an alternative if you need, which is why I give you that kind of bent knee off to the right side version, which usually relieves any knee stuff. But it might not, in which case, find something else. Connect down into the ground. Connect down with the pinky side of your right foot. Notice the right shin, the back foot. And then And energetically, just like when we were in crescent or when we were in anjaneyasana, gently draw the legs toward each other. This is like the instructions I give, like when I, especially when I say gently, that's like 10% effort maybe. Like not 100%, not 60%, like 10%, nice and gently. It's really hard to sustain 100% all the time. Excuse me. Even like 75% all the time, even 50% all the time. But when we go kind of like with a gentler approach of like maybe a 10%, maybe a 40% effort, so that we still have some softness, we still have some ease, we can actually sustain. It's not passive, it's not complacent, it's active, it's just at a sort of a hum you can sustain. Good, come up onto your hands. Tuck the back toes. Come into plank. Put your knees on the ground. Rise up, Ustrasana. Come back up, inhale. Forearms to the ground. This time, dolphin. If it feels okay, tuck the toes, lift the hips. Push the ground away. Dolphin doesn't feel good. I didn't give you the alternative, but it would have been forearm plank or even just a child's pose if you want. Good. Bend your knees. Look forward toward your hands. If you're in a plank, walk your feet in a little closer. Press into your hands, lift up to plank, and then downward facing dog. Left leg stretches back, inhale. Left knee to right elbow. Extend the left leg out to the right. Stay up on the pinky toes, pull the heart forward, pull the gaze forward. Dig this pinky side of the foot down and imagine you could drag it over to the left a little bit. Yes. And then pull forward a little more from the heart. Use the back toes. Mm-hmm. You're perfect. Yep. Yep, yep, yep. Good. And then inhale, three-legged dog. Open the front of the left hip if it feels good. If you like wild thing, go ahead, flip over. If you don't, leave it off. Or if you just don't feel like it today. There's a reminder that just because you can do something doesn't mean that you have to or that you need to or that you have to want to. Bring your left hand around. Step your left foot outside of your left hand and then right knee gently to the ground. You can stay there. You can reach back, find your knee. I'm sorry, find your foot. And then if you want, you can lift up right. Engage the right glute. Squeeze that cheek. One more breath in. And then release. Walk your left foot over to the right. Single leg pigeon or any variation of it. So again, if this doesn't feel good, consider just kind of rolling off onto your left hip and then bending this knee and then seeing what you can get from it. There was a time I would have like aligned you right out of that, what I just showed you. And now I'm like, if that feels good, that's where you need to be. Don't suffer in a pose that doesn't work on your body. Adapt the pose to work for you. And then when you found that place, be awake in it, be alive in it. Give me like a little effort here. Back foot, back leg, front shin, front foot. So rooting down to receive energy back. Practice is so unique because it is available to everyone in some form. Each pose is available to everyone in some form. And you don't have to feel bad for doing a quieter version of the pose, and you don't have to feel bad about doing a bigger version of the pose either. So it's like stay in your lane, right? You don't have to worry about what someone else is doing. Just be concerned with yourself, taking care of yourself. Good, bring your hands under your shoulders. Tuck your back toes and then step back to plank. Bring your knees down. And then any form of Ustrasana. This is Ustrasana, by the way. Like this is Ustrasana. Engage the glutes, push the feet down, push the knees down, lift the heart. Maybe you find a deeper version. Who cares? Your version is perfect on you today. And I'm all about 100% kind of pushing your boundaries, but knowing where you need to be also. Rise with an inhale. So good. Forearms come down to the ground. Dolphin or forearm plank. That was a little more specific this time. Good. Beautiful. Good. If you're in forearm plank, walk your feet in just a couple steps. Everybody, look toward your thumbs, bend your knees, and then see if you can lift up into downward facing dog. Take a few breaths here. Inhale, lift your heels high. Bend your knees deeply. Bring your feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Chair, inhale. Start to sink down. You're gonna make your way to seated. It doesn't have to be from here. It's however you wanna get there. Good, perfect. Soles of the feet together, Baddha Konasana. Yes, draw the heart up and then come forward any amount. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. Good, good, good. Inhale, rise up. Bring your knees in together. Good. Navasana. I'm going to go modified version hands behind my hips here so that I don't crush my tailbone. But you're welcome to reach your hands forward. You're welcome to straighten out your legs. I'm just not going to do it today. I'm getting closer, but I'm not quite there. Good. Right foot comes in, left leg extends out. Janu Shirshasana, come forward. Beautiful. Good. You're going to take your foot. If that means that you need to bend your knee to take your foot, you're going to bend your knee to take your foot. And then you're going to lift your leg up. Mm-hmm. I'm going to turn a little on an angle here. Yep. Beautiful. Really nice. Good. You don't have to change anything. This is perfect. If you want, right hand goes to your left foot, and then we twist, reaching the left hand back. Come back through center. Good. Bring both feet down, recenter, and then boat pose again. Mm-hmm. And then left foot in, right leg out. That'd be great. Left foot in, left foot out. That'd be impossible. Left foot in, right leg out, and then come forward. Janu Shirshasana. Deepen the crease of the right hip. Send the heart toward your foot. Thank you. Good. You're going to find your left foot however you need to get there. You're going to lift up that right leg. This is what happens when I try and mirror you. Beautiful. This is perfect. This doesn't have to change. This leg doesn't have to be straight. I don't know if I mentioned that. It does not have to be straight. Take your foot if you want with your left hand and then twist. Right hand goes back. Back through center. Good. Bring the feet back together, Baddha Konasana again. Really nice. Rise back up. Extend the legs out. Upavishta Konasana. Good. Beautiful. Good. You don't have to come forward. If it feels good, you can. Beautiful. Yes. Inhale, rising up. Good. Bring the knees back in. Come onto your backs. Really nice work. Give yourself a squeeze with your knees. Or to your knees. Squeeze your knees to you. And then put your right foot flat on the ground, knee bent, cross your left ankle on your right thigh. Just like we started, open that left knee out, arms out to the side in any shape. And then drop the legs to the right. See how it feels. Back to center. Put your left foot down, cross right ankle to left thigh. Open the knee. Knees to the left, or legs to the left. You're gently pressing that right knee away from your torso. Come back to center. Both knees back in. Don't touch the legs though, just draw the knees in. Take the knees out wide. Take the knees as wide as you can and draw your feet toward your hips without touching anything. Reach down with your hands, take the inner heels, and then draw open, or not. Happy baby, only if it feels good. Good. Beautiful. And then release for Shavasana. Take the legs out, turn the palms up, close your eyes, and release into the ground. Allow your breath to get quiet. Allow your body to get quiet.
Thank you.
feel the weight of your body in the ground. Come back to your breath. Come back to the air around you. Wake up your hands, wake up your feet. Gradually start to bring movement back into your body. And when you're ready, stretch the arms overhead. Bend your knees, roll to your side. From your side, rise up to a comfortable sitting position. When you have arrived, bring your hands together at your heart. In this last moment together, honoring the space we hold, the practice we share, honoring yourself for being here, for giving yourself this time. Together, draw the heart up, bow your mind to your heart. Rise back with your inhale, eyes open gently. Thank you for your practice.